We are live.
Well, how exciting. Oh, I can't see myself.
This is your artist page?
Yeah.
Where's the live thing?
Go back down to the top. No, that's not my artist page.
Okay, where's your artist page?
I don't know.
Well, we're on.
No. Yeah, try that. You gotta type in...
Oh, it's here. Here we go. Here we go. And then we go.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
There it is.
There you go.
There it is.
6:59. I'm not doing anything yet. Wow, come on, I can't see myself.
Oh, there you are.
Oh.
There it comes. There you are. Hey. Hey, quiet down.
Hey, people. 6:59. I'm not doing anything till it's time. Oh, look, we already got people.
Hello, hey, people. Peeps.
Jay Francis, what a legend. Stoney joined. Hey, Stoney. I guess you figured the time zone out without asking for help. Google, remember? Google, Stoney. Jarvis is here from Canada. Anametta. Anna Storm. I don't think she's in Norway. I think she's in Minnesota. Lisa Loftus put a lot of hearts there. Stoney says, "G'day, punk." Can you know how to block people?
No, should I? Should I block them?
If you could research that.
Sure.
We might need to do that with that guy. He's from Tasmania.
No doubt.
And I got to tell you. Yeah. There's the wine. Can you see the wine? Can they see the wine? They can see the wine. You know what? I should have done the Christian thing and put it in a Starbucks mug. Now that would have been better.
That's debatable, but I hear you.
Oh, it's all right though. I've been able to hide this tequila as water. Well, people, hi there. Good to see ya. Jana Gibbons Lively. I've been teaching her kids. And they are incredible.
Nice.
Well, no, Jana, but I keep wanting to say Jana, because normally when I see that name, it's in Scandinavia. Hi from Canada. You and your music, exactly what I need tonight. Really? I better be on my A game.
Do they realize you're not playing anything?
Yeah, I'm just talking tonight.
Right.
Do you not know?
Holding the guitar and talking, that's the plan.
I mean, I'm just doing it to hide my guts.
Right.
I mean, that's what you do when you...
That's why I play.
Ed from California. All right, Ed. Can you send me some In-N-Out Burger? Speaking of guts.
Delicious.
Maureen. Woohoo! Aiden Hall. Aiden is in Australia. His parents came and saw me every Friday night.
Wow.
Playing at these divey pubs.
Why didn't he come?
He was a child.
Oh, right.
Matter of fact, I'm not sure he was even born then. Birgit's here. We've got Germans. We've got Australians. We've got... What else do you need? Aaron, what's up? Hi, Paul. Amy, how you doing? So, here's the deal, my friends. The first time I did a show, when was that, Jeremy? Was it sort of in the very early days of quarantine?
Yeah, a couple months ago.
Was it?
I think so.
Wow.
March? March is what we're hearing from the...
March.
The backstage area.
March.
Yes.
Okay. So that was the first show. And what I kind of did on my first show was... You know, the songs that I normally play.
Sure.
You know, I mean, after a while, you whittle it down to, I wouldn't say the hits, because I think that's a bit presumptuous for someone with my career to say hits, but let's just say the more popular songs that I've played. And then I thought for the second show, let's dig a little deeper, you know? Oh, Jeremy. What are you doing?
I'm getting notes from someone that we need the mic closer to you, so...
Oh, well, you could also turn the volume up, but then again, you've scotch-taped it. No, it's on the side of the phone.
Will that do anything for the mic, though?
Will it?
I don't believe so, but...
All right.
Hopefully that's better.
Is that better? Problem is, it's closer to my face.
There's
a casualty involved.
You are the star here.
Really?
Yeah.
Stop it.
I mean, come on.
Anyway, back to me. Right. I was expecting a laugh then.
Oh!
That's what I like. Live canned laughter. What was I saying about myself? did you remember what I was saying?
No.
It's my ADD, as soon as you moved and got up.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, my first show. Where? Oh, my first show here.
March.
You came over.
Right.
We had a great time. Second set, I thought, you know, I might just try and play songs that I didn't do in the first one. And so I actually had to relearn a bunch of songs. So in this third one, I decided to do that again. So this is not quite scraping the barrel yet, but there is a couple of the songs in this set list. One of them that I have not sung since 1996. Oh, they want...
They're saying it's not better.
Not any better. That's Cheyenne. She is a very good singer and songwriter, guitar player. I would take her opinion. They can see my Gallagher machine now. Mm. That's good.
Nice.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, that angle. Jesus, I wish I had looked at myself on that angle. Oh. Oof. That angle is brought to you by Five Guys. So, on this set, no songs that I played before. I did a little bit of Down Under on the second show, but not all of it. So yeah, so the set list, we've got the fourth song tonight, The Reunion, was a song on my very, very first record called The Band Thing, which came out in 96. And then there's a song called As Long As You Come Home To Me that I'm going to play that comes from a record from 1998 that I have not played since probably 98. I'm going to try my country version of Shine by the Newsboys tonight. That should please at least me. A few songs. Another Newsboys song. Why not? Why not, eh? They play that song every night. I co-wrote it. Might as well do them the favour of doing it again. All right, so I'm going to start off with Down Under by Men at Work. This is a song I start a lot of my shows with, and usually it's because it's a bit silly, it's a bit funny, and I get to have a look at people and scan the crowd looking for what's going to happen in the evening without throwing out a song with precious lyrics. Instead, I'm just singing about a bunch of stuff I'm not sure any of us really understand. Let's get this kind of reggae-y. Jerry's head moving. Boy, what's up back there? Sometimes I'll say stuff like that. I don't know what it is, but it gets my voice warmed up. Boy, you didn't understand how that was called over there. Pentecostals usually understand what I'm saying. Whoa. And then I sometimes just go buying bread because I have to remind myself what I'm going to do after the show. Co-write this. If I did. did I be coming to you from a mansion? I did not co-write this. That was a song called Something Beautiful. Lying in the den in Bombay, rubby rubber beats up a root. With a slap jaw, not much to say. Oh, God. Never do matter, you're trying to tempt me. Because I come from the land of plenty. And everybody at home say, here you go. Come on, don't be afraid. Us flow and then chunder. I don't think Americans ever really understood that line.
Yeah, they chunder.
Where beer does flow and then chunder. Now, chunder in Australia is slang for throwing up. So it's like, oh, mate, food make you chunder? Yeah, that horrible chunder. Yeah. So when they say, living in land down under. Next song I'd like to sing, I'd like to dedicate to all you Canadians out there. Ah, Mariah. Mariah Beltz. What a fantastic young lady from up there in New England. Hey, Mariah, how you doing? It's me, Polly. Yeah. Yeah, I heard you guys had some summer. That was wicked. Snow everywhere. 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know what's happening tonight with this. What it is, I've been getting up at 6:45 a.m. and doing other things. And so this is like releasing the endorphins of music. Anyway. Timothy Ward, Ramona Henry Bishop. Cool name. Janelle Cuthbert. Mariah. Good. LOL. Does that mean lots of love?
No. Laughing out loud. Oh, okay.
I'm kidding.
I really thought you didn't know.
I love the fact that you didn't know that. Yeah. I knew. I like to sing a song for all the Canadians out there. Well, for everyone. But this is by one of my favorite Canadian artists. It's a song called Walking in Memphis. And I'd like to tell you two brief anecdotes about this. Number one is that when I first sang this, I didn't know what Beale Street was. So when it said, with my feet off Beale, I didn't know Beale was a street. And every time I sang it, I'd go, what's a Beale? The second thing is that a friend of mine was running for governor of Tennessee. He was a congressman I met him years ago. And he was running for governor. And he said, Paul, do you want to come down to Memphis? I'm doing a rally down there. Do you want to come and sing? And you know the song Walking in Memphis? And I said, yeah, I'll sing that. So we went down to this tour bus that was wrapped with his name and the American flag. And I got up and sang this song. Moderate response. I mean, they were there to hear him. He spoke. It was great. We thought he was going to win. On the way back in the bus, I said, mate, do you know that I can't vote? And he goes, don't tell anybody that. So anyway, dedicate this to any Canadians out there. Anyone running for governor? I'm available. I can sing Sweet Home Chicago. I can sing Kansas City. Matter of fact, run your whole campaign on songs and I'll be there. Put on my blue suede shoes and boarded the plane. I touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of a pouring rain. W.C. Handy, won't you look down over me? Well, I got a first class ticket, but I'm as blue as a boy can be. And I'm walking in Memphis. Walking with my feet 10 feet off a Beale. What's a Beale? Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Do you really feel the way? I feel. Saw the ghost of Elvis on Union Avenue. I followed him up to the gates of Graceland. Saw him walk right through. With security, they did not see him. They just hovered around his tomb. There's a pretty little thing waiting for the king down in the jungle room. I'm walking in Memphis.
In Memphis.
Couldn't help us out to find folks.
Yeah.
Jungle room, walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Walking with my feet 10 feet out the field. What's the deal? Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Do you really feel the way I feel? Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. They've got catfish on the table. You ready? They've got gospel in the air. Woo-hoo. Reverend Green, I'll be glad to see you when you haven't got a prayer. Well, you got a prayer in Memphis. Now Muriel plays piano every Friday at the Hollywood. Hey, they asked me down to see her. Yeah, they asked me if I would. We do a little number, and I sang with all my might. She said, hey, Polly Pops, are you a Christian child? And I said, I don't call myself that, but probably tonight. And I'm walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Walking with my feet 10 feet off a beer. What's a beer? Street. Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Do you really feel the way I feel? Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Walking with my feet 10 feet off of me, yeah. Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Do you really feel the way I feel? Sometimes I do this to freak out the sound guy. Put on my blue suede shoes and boarded the plane. I touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of the pouring rain, rain, rain. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of the pouring rain, rain, rain. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of the pouring rain. We got some good comments happening tonight, Jeremy.
We certainly do.
Hey, that's Tom.
Go back a bit. Right here?
No, back, Tom. Oh, yeah, Tom. Tom is from Holland. Tom, what are you doing awake? What time is it in Holland? It's like 3 a.m. He's probably up with a stroopwafel. You probably don't know what that is.
I still don't know what Beale is. I mean, I know it's a street.
It's a street. It's Beale Street.
But why is it called Beale Street? Tell me the history of Beale Street.
Barry Beale.
Oh, right.
He's
right.
The founder of the Memphis streets that were.
The Memphis Street Society.
Memphis, the MSS.
Yes, right.
Yes, and he was a Beale guy.
He died in 2014. Did you know that?
No, he did not. That was his grandson.
Right. He's going to outlive them all.
Yeah. And yeah. Betty Beale, his wife, still around.
Good for you, Betty and Barry.
You know, I was going to ask people about donating, but I'm not sure right now. Hey, folks, you can donate. I am doing this for love, but I'm also doing it because bills are looming, and it's tough times for performing musicians. So you can just go to paulcolmanofficial.com, and there's a Venmo.
Right.
Actually, that's just at Paul Colman. No Ian Colman. Boy, I wish there was. All right, so I'm going to sing a song now that many of you... my favorite smoothie, Andy Beeston. Mate, I haven't seen him for a while. My favorite smoothie, easily, is the PC3 smoothie in Launceston. Duh. Yeah, so there you can see someone has shown you where you can donate. RJ, I wish...
The best is yet to come.
No, where's RJ? Right here. Robert Ball there. I wish I could do the song, The Best Is Yet to Go. Yeah, that might be a parody of my song, I'm not sure. It might have been a slip of the old fingers on the keyboard there, RJ. But actually, that kid is an awesome kid. He's a good rapper. There he is. He changed it. Went to school with my daughter Katie through high school. One of my favorite kids.
She's 18 now.
She's 18. So is he?
Yeah.
All right. So this is a song called When, and I wrote it on my 51st birthday.
Is that like what, 10 years ago?
Oh.
Dear. Yeah, you walked into that one.
Oh dear. Mm-hmm. Oh dear.
Mm-hmm.
This is called When.
When is it?
It's going to happen right now. This has not been recorded yet. But I will tell you this, that when I sang this in Norway in January with my good friend Anna Storm, it was the first time I had really enjoyed it. Because she added something very good to it. So this is called When. If you're listening, Anna, dedicate this to the couple of nights we played to less than 10 people. But we didn't show them on Facebook, did? Oh wait, 10 people now. Alright, with When. I'd like to dedicate this to anyone who has found it hard to accept love. So everybody. When? That would be one of those times in the studio where we go, let's start that again. Why is that? Oh, I don't know. I thought we might start in the same key. What do you think?
A lot of those times.
When?
Yeah.
When? That's the note. Everybody sing it. When? Okay. I'm not following some of you. When? All right, here we go.
Love you.
got a bit excited during that one.
I liked it.
Yeah. How we go? Oh, blank screen. Okay, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's...
What's happened? Have we
it's
lost?
Getting slow. No, we're still broadcasting. We're
still broadcasting. When you say it's getting slow, meaning the computer? Or...
Yes.
Okay, I thought you meant like the love coming back from the people.
your love is slow. Their love is slow. No.
Folks, this is a song that I would be shocked if any of you really knew. It's off my first album. And the album was called The Band Thing. I didn't know what I wanted to sound like. Some of the songs, it really could be called, the album could be called Crapload of Genres. This song was, Stone Temple Pilots and Pearl Jam were pretty big in the mid-90s. So it's got a bit of that, but the ultimate fear for me was going to my high school reunion, because I am not a big fan of who I perceive myself to have been at school. I just don't want to go back and face people. I remember once when I left school, and 5 years later I saw a kid down at the beach, and I saw him and I thought, oh, I still remember the guy's name. And I thought, oh, there, that's cool, that's so-and-so. And he walked up to me and he goes, Paul Colman, the biggest dickhead at our school.
Wow, really?
That was what he said to me. And so it crushed me. So the idea of going back to my high school reunion, even now, I've ignored them all. So I will tell you the truth is, this is about a fictitious event. I did not go to my high school reunion. But I decided to write a song in case I was that gutsy. So this is on the record, The Band Thing, this is a pretty heavy rock and roll song, but this is the acoustic version of how I wrote it. And I believe that The Halls requested this. So this is the reunion.
Rejection.
So I took my invitation and the freedom that I'd won, and I headed from my high school reunion. And then there's a massive guitar solo. Which will not be performed tonight. So I think I'm still not strong enough to go to my high school reunion. I still feel too fat to go. I still feel the rejection from school is still strong. It's still there. Taste it. It was so bad. Like, it wasn't one kid. It was the whole school that just would line me up against the wall and punch me in the face. And it happened everywhere. And so I've never forgotten it, which is why usually around the world I pick up kids and collect them as friends that have been bullied, or I just had that, because I just know what it feels like, and I befriend them and I love them and I encourage them. This next one I've not performed, I think, since about 98. I wrote it for a friend of mine. An awesome musician. Oh, boy, if you heard this person play, you would just so soulful and amazing. And he married this girl that was very symmetrical and was celebrated for her symmetricity.
Interesting.
What we call good looking, which really just means symmetrical. And he said to me one night, he said, you know, I got a feeling that she's kind of not being faithful to me. And he said, I don't want to believe it, but all my friends say they've seen her at clubs. And he said, man, I don't know, as long as she comes home to me. And as soon as he said that, I thought, that's a great song. So I wrote this song for him. And when we used to sing it together, well, when I used to play it and we were in a duo, he would sit there with a lap steel guitar and his hair hanging down, he would just weep because the song is just so what happened. So this is off my album One Voice, One Guitar, recorded in a Melbourne kitchen live to DAT tape in 4 hours. And I think this was just one take, which is what's going to happen right now. So this is called As Long As You Come Home To Me. Simple guy, it's a long road. Never wanted much, but what I have, don't let go. When I met you, love, you took my breath away. You turn heads in the street, your beauty radiates. I'm not a jealous guy, and I want you to know, baby, I guess I don't mind where you go. I'd love you till you die. Baby, I'm no fool. Girl, I give you trust. I won't tie a string. But if you got another love, well, I'll pack up all my things. And you'll have yourself to blame for not doing the right thing by me. So just be careful where you go. Come on home to me. Come on home to me. Oh, you know I love you, baby. You gotta come on home.
To say, I really loved that version a lot.
Yeah, it's a good song. So, folks, as much as it is awkward to say it, you can donate on Venmo at Paul Colman. No E, don't give it to some other guy with an E in his name. He's not standing here doing this or sitting. You can also at PayPal. You can find all of these places to donate at paulcolmanofficial.com, and that would be really appreciated. I've actually begun a new career, and I'm going to tell you a bit more about that later, but I haven't been paid yet. But I've put in a lot of time. Anyway, next song. Oh, Something Beautiful by the Newsboys. This song is an ode to persistence. Because I went to the studio when I was in the Newsboys with Peter Furler, who was the main songwriter. And I went to the studio all the time just hoping to pick up some crumbs from the table. And he was playing me demos. What do you think of this? What do you think of that? What do you think? If you hang around long enough, someone will go, what do you think? And he played me this Something Beautiful idea. I said, man, that is awesome. And so that night we finished this song together. I'm quite happy to say that the Newsboys still perform this, which is quite good. So this is my acoustic folk version of Something Beautiful.
Take us.
Well, now I'm going to try and attempt something a little bit foolish. And that is, I'm going to try and do a country version of the Newsboys song Shine. I actually did a version of this in the studio. I'm going to dig it up and I'm going to put it up on my website, paulcolmanofficial.com. No E in Colman. While you're there, why not donate? Sorry, what? Yeah. You know, you heard me. So this is a strange... Every time I've rehearsed this, I haven't quite got the verse the same. It's a very bizarre song. This was a time when the genre we know as Christian music could be playful. This was a time where you could be creative. This was before everyone started writing songs telling God what he already knows about himself and forgot about the dictionary and forgot about metaphor and forgot about fun. But these are the great old days when that happened. So this is my country version of the Newsboys song Shine. If you would like to hear the original, I'm sure it's on every platform possible. Shine, country. Shine, make them wonder what you got. Make them wish that they were not on the outside looking bored. Shine, make them shine before all men. Make them see works in them, let them glorify the Lord. Well, dull Esther, you can't assert the kind of light that might dissuade strange dictators to retire. Fight the army, teach the poor origami. The truth is in, the truth is when you hear your heart set saying, what's my motivation? Yeah, try as you may, there ain't no way to explain that kind of change. Make a vegetarian barbecue hamster. Unless you can trace this about face to a certain sign. Shine, make them wonder what you got. Yeah, make them wish that they were not on the outside looking for. Shine, make them shine before all men. Make them little, 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 little. Make a schizophrenic turn on his grill. Over freaks and science seeks a rationale that shall excuse this strange behavior. When you let it shine, you will inspire the kind of untied turnaround that will make a bounce and turn ballet. Even bounces you want to call Jeremy. Out of the clear and nowhere to turn, you ain't gonna learn it all. What's my line? Shine! Make them wonder what you got. Make them wish that they were not on the outside looking home. Shine, make them shine before all men, women, their virtues and them, let them glorify the Lord. Oh, I see a sad face there from someone. Now, when I was in the band, I made the mistake one day of doing my Bob Dylan version of this song.
Yes.
Someone asked for it.
Yeah, right there. They were expecting it. Furler fan was
a fan, yeah, Bob Dylan. So, even at Angel Stadium in front of 60,000 people, Peter would stop this song and make me sing the Bob Dylan version of Shine. So here it is.
Shine, make them wonder what you got. Make them wish that they were not on the outside looking above. Everybody's gotta shine. Make them shine before all men. Yeah, let them see your twist and then. Glorify the Lord. Shine.
Well so, done.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well done.
Thank you. The next song is called Sun, Stars, Moon, and I'm not doing it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Oh.
I'm sorry. It's a good song, but when I was rehearsing it, didn't sound that great, to be quite honest. And there's this riff that I wrote that goes like this. And I did it once in the studio, and then we just cut and pasted it, because...
That's what you do.
I was right on the edge of my talent level. So sorry about that. I guess you feel ripped off. That's okay. Is Jason Patrick here? Is my friend Jason Patrick one of my dear friends in Australia, Jason Patrick. Jason and I chat about our mental health. We encourage each other. Sometimes our mental health is better than others. Sometimes it's not as good, and we chat about it, and we realize that we're loved just the way we are, but we do have some challenges. And Jason asked for this song. So Jason, if you're not watching, at least you can watch the, what you call it, a replay?
The recording of it.
The recording. So sure. That's the word I was trying to find. Oh.
Lori just said, yes, he's there.
Oh, Jason's there. Love you, Jason. I love the ball, by the way. So handsome. So Jason asked me to sing this song. Can't remember what capo it's on. It's got to be one of them. I always use a capo.
He just said, yo. Jason just said, yo.
Hey,
and he gave you love.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. It wasn't just a yo. That was a definite love.
A yo with love. It's, yeah, I mean, that's, you're right.
You know what I'm saying? That's yo love. That's a special kind of love. There's agape. There's rhema. And then there's yo love.
Yo love.
Which is, you know, how deep is yo love, for example. That's a famous song.
How deep is yo love?
How deep is Jason's love? It's Jason, whoa. That's Jason Boy here. He is an incredible musician from Melbourne, Australia. Oh my gosh. You should see that guy play. He's a legend. Hey, he's on my concert. Can you take a screenshot of that?
I will. Yes.
I'll put that on my website.
Yeah.
Jason. Legend. Okay, so another Jason. Jason Patrick, this is for you. This was probably the first song I wrote where I thought, maybe I can write songs. I don't know. I think I wrote it when I was like 20. So it's just 10 years ago now.
I was going to say like 60, 70 years ago? Like 60.
In case you've not been on this before, this is Jeremy. And he expresses love with abuse. I got to tell you, I received it. Okay, so this is called Small Steps. This was recorded on an album called One Voice, One Guitar, Volume 2. I'd already done One Voice, One Guitar, and I spent weeks trying to come up with a title. And eventually, I found it. Just throw the old Volume 2 on there. You know what I mean?
Well done.
Yeah, you're welcome. Come to you from the same guy that came up with the band name, the Paul Colman Trio. Oh, yeah. Came to me in a dream. Okay. Small Steps.
Glory with my Lord. so they simply play the part. Well, I'm not scared to walk around with my heart out on my sleeve, bringing peace and words to sorrow, to the hearts that I may bruise. I'm taking small steps to glory. Taking small steps to glory with my Lord. With my Lord. And I know when I smile, it's a smile from my heart. And although that I'm not far down the road to where you are, yeah.
Hurts my fingers. It hurts my fingers, it does. So anyone interested in what my new job is, my new change of career? I've been at it for 3 weeks now. I've been on Zoom calls at 6:45 a.m. for 3 weeks. I've been awake and productive before 7 in the last 3 weeks, more than my entire life, times 5. I have an office that I'm going to. I have a cubicle that I was assigned today. A cubicle! My daughter Katie came around to my office and said, Are you really doing this? I had to get my state license to do this. I had 2 tests. I passed one, I failed the other by 3 points. But the testing areas are so full that I have to drive to Alabama next Thursday to do that one. What is the career, I hear you ask? Oh, not so fast, peeps, not so fast. I've got to try to keep you here a little longer. By the way, I may not have mentioned this, even though I have a new job, I've not been paid yet. It's all commission-based. No. I'm not door-to-door selling Bibles or anything like that.
Fidget spinners.
I told you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Sorry, guys.
I have a cubicle where I can test my fidget spinners. No, not fidget spinners. Some of you probably want to know. Oh, wait. Shame on you, Jeremy. We don't use the word shame. Heather Masters, love this one. Hey, Heather, darling. Love you. Love your husband, too. Heather's husband, he does the greatest Maine trucker's accent, so we call him Chopper Charlie. He's the best. Birgit, man, that brings back memories to the early 2010s. And Herbert Burton III. I think that's the name of the knight.
It's a nice name.
That's a nice name. Listen to this. Paul Colman. Now listen to this. Herbert Burton III. That's a great name. Okay, you can click off those. Who's back now? I think maybe. Hi, Cindy. How you doing? Hi, Kimmy. Hi.
Right. So,
if there's a few people that Chopper Charlie says hi. If there's a few people, Andrew Anthony, insurance salesman, maybe. Hey, feel free to guess. Matter of fact, over the next couple of songs, have a guess.
It's a good idea.
Now, I'm going to go to the piano now. And so we're going to test our high-tech. I wish you could see the phone scotch-taped onto a...
It's beautiful.
It's gorgeous. I'm going to go to the piano and I'm going to sing a song, actually quite a serious song, that I wrote right after I got separated from my now ex-wife, and I was in the house by myself just for days on end, and I wasn't used to it, and I just hoped that we could at some point be friends. And that's where this song kind of came from. So I'm leaving Studio A, I'm heading over to Studio B where the piano is. You're about to see more of my pretty great apartment. Okay, this is me now traveling, and Jeremy, who's left his bag underneath my stuff.
I needed to put it there.
Goodness me, Jeremy.
It was right.
Are you catching me on my thin side here?
That's right.
Okay. front of me is the temperature controls. This is what my daughters like to mess with when they come to my apartment. I like it cold. What'd you say? Oh, really? Okay. Yeah. Can you hear that? Is it loud enough? Give me a thumbs up if you guys can hear my voice over the piano. La la la, testing, yeah. I'm just testing you. How's that? Any thumbs up? Any good news from people? All right, this song is called The Second Time Around. It was recorded in 2015 by Jeremy Michael.
Thank you very much.
On my Recalculating album. And Klaas P. Ambor says that he co-wrote this with me, and I put his name on it, but honestly, I actually think he's lying. I don't think he did a damn thing.
Thank you.
time around.
One of my favorites on that record, Paul.
Really?
Yep.
I like the string section.
Oh.
Oh, we're back. Oh, dear. Oh, wow. You guys still hanging in there? Thanks for hanging with me. Love the piano. Yeah, it's a nice piano, that. Oh, it looks like I'm posting my own messages there, but that's actually Jeremy.
What? I didn't say anything. What
it says Paul Colman here. I hope you pay my bills.
No, somebody, I don't know who that is.
Someone who's very kind. Olivia. Hey, Olivia. All your time and attention is focused on your work. Did I hear a jazz chord? F major 7. I can play a jazz chord if you like. A jazz chord to say. Mark Evans joined. What's up, Mark? I love everything about you except your football team, who I hate with a passion. Benny and the Jets. All right, so what are we up to next?
Benny and the Jets.
Oh, okay. This song I wrote for a beautiful, beautiful person that grew up with a family that he shamed.
Sorry.
Jeremy's finding it hard to hold his bourbon.
Technical difficulties.
Hey, Brenda. Hey, guys. I so appreciate you guys being... Lawrence Hall, thanks for playing Reunion. First time in 24 years, Loza. Woo! Woo! So I'd like to dedicate this to anyone that grew up being shamed. Matter of fact, I don't even like it when someone says shame on someone. Don't put shame on anyone. No matter what they've done, don't put shame on someone. Because shame is very destructive. Shame says there's something wrong with you. The voice of shame says, you're only loved because of this that you do, or if you were like this you would be beautiful, or if you could do that you could be clever, if you looked like this person, if you acted like that person. Shame points. My guitar was trying to play the other guitar. Shame on you. No, don't say that. Shame is a destructive force, and in the mid-2000s I realized that I lived constantly drowning in a black hole of shame. And I did not even know the word until then. And I realized that I felt shame in every part of me. Shame says, everyone else is fine, but not you. You're not like everyone else. So shame is horrible. And this person that I wrote this song for, I dearly love. And so I decided to put some of her story into a song. So it's called The Voice of Shame. It's got a bit of a country feel to it. I did make a demo to this that I might release. We'll see. Anyone inquisitive about my new career? Any guesses up there, Jeremy?
We have a few guesses.
What are the guesses?
A couple insurance salesmen. We have
insurance salesmen. People said that.
Yes, a couple of them. Yeah.
People look at me and think insurance salesman.
Well, that's
It Charles Person? Isn't that the correct
insurance person?
Insurance salesperson.
Oh, salesperson. Yeah. Perhaps.
I mean, then again, my name could get a bit of a beating. Called Paul Cole Person. Can't really.
Colbert.
You know what I mean? It's not the same.
Right. Right.
Okay, so we've had a few people say insurance salesman. Yes. Anything else?
I don't... We have had a couple others. What are those?
Jeremy, are you doing your job? Because I know
it
I'm
was
doing
telephone sales.
Telephone sales?
Yes.
Real estate.
So
real estate.
Selling telephones?
No, real estate.
No, over the phone sales. Just generic.
Okay. Just selling whatever.
Right.
Anyone else?
Fidget spinners, clearly.
No.
If you feel Polly Pops should not be domesticated to an office.
Brian Mitchell. Now, Brian Mitchell, apart from being a devilishly handsome man, Brian Mitchell was in the record company that signed the Paul Colman Trio. Thanks, Brian. Kelly Taylor. G'day, Kelly Taylor. Timothy Needham. Sue McGuinness. Hey, Sue McGuinness is my neuropsychologist. Do you know what she's going to do? She's going to put things in here and analyze my brain.
Is she going to explain a lot of things?
Well, you know what's really funny? And this made me laugh, is that she's come to this festival in New Hampshire that I played at for 20 years. And when I started talking to her about having dyslexia things and stuff going on, she goes, I'm so glad to hear you say this. And I said, why? And she goes, because for the last 5 or 6 years, I've always been thinking, boy, I would love to get a reading on that guy's brain. When she said that, I felt so loved. I thought someone out there has thought, boy, wouldn't it be good to see what's going on under the cover of that, you know, under the hood. Anyway, so this is called, hey, Lexi. Lexi is one of my students, a magnificent, well, she's one of Josiah's students now. Anyway, back to seriousness, shame. If you have shame, it's time to get rid of it. Tell shame to get, you know what I'm saying? Just add a Christian cuss word in there. Then you feel better. So this is called The Voice of Shame. Well, they told her, get out of the way. Go sit in the corner. Or go outside and play. And they told her, you'll just have to wait till our dinner is over before you fill your plate. She said, Mama, I'm thirsty. Can I please have a drink? Her mama said, I'm busy, child. So what do you think? So she sat in the shadows, yeah, watching the clouds from out of the window, not making a sound. Can you see that sweet little girl running day by day to apologize to the world for taking up space? And no matter what you do, there's something really wrong with you. Those filthy words whispered by the voice of shame. Well, he told her, you're never enough. If you want me to love you, get a measure up. With a house full of children and everything in his name, she did what he told her, took all the blame. Can you see that sweet, pretty girl living day by day to apologize to the world for taking up space? Cause no matter what you do, there's something really wrong with you. Familiar words whispered by the voice of shame. Now, Daddy was a hero. She said the only one could always love her, no matter what she'd done. But he left her in the winter, passed through her like a ghost. She still hears him say, girl, you're never alone. She's a soldier, a fighter for love. Yeah, whatever the battle, she's gonna rise above. Now she's singing a brand new song, saying I'm just perfect, I've been all along. Can you see that sweet, pretty girl living day by day? Not to apologize to the world for taking up space. Cause no matter what you do, there's nothing really wrong with you. Go to hell, she whispered to the voice of shame.
Nice song, Paulie.
I like that song.
We finally got a lot of really good guesses.
Okay, here we go. Sue, I'm sure that brain is amazing. Yes, Sue, I want you to know I never felt anything bad from you saying, boy, I'd like to analyze that guy. I felt loved. I felt loved by that. Interior decorator, Mike. Mike, you've been on the golf course drinking too much this week with your wife. Amy Anderson, a doctor. Sorry. You would not want me as your doctor. You know, like, I'm not accurate like that.
I like the next one.
Professional bowler.
Yes. Yes.
Wow. Now that's a gutter bowler. Golf commentator. Oh, yeah.
That would work.
Yeah, that's not bad.
But you got to say golf.
Ah, golf.
Yeah.
On the golf course.
The Golf Channel will only let you be there if you say golf.
Oh, look at this name. What a cool name. Atle Paulshood. Driving school teacher. Not a bad idea. Adam, where are you from? You sound Scandinavian-ish. And Lisa, yes, Paul Colman, please release Shane. Ah, yeah. The voice of Shane. Oh, gosh. Kimmy, since I'm a bra salesman. Man, would that be the deal, the C-cup? No, I don't think so.
Let me run to the back.
Michelle Thompson. Tomo! Tomo, what did you say?
Let me run to the back and check on that.
You mean the...
We might have that in your size.
We might have that. No, I can't do that. Real estate? No, not real estate.
Oh, school teacher. No. You've been that.
No, I can't take the pay cut.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Wine taster.
Ooh.
Oh, wait, well, let me practice that.
That's a fun job.
Wait.
Yeah, that worked. What? Yeah.
As you can tell, I'm still in training. Wait,
Hence the 6:45 mornings, yeah.
Oh, you know what? Yep, that's a box wine.
Sitting in your cubicle, swirling your
that's
wine.
That's a 2019 box wine. Norway, yeah, sounded like it. Dude, you're up in the middle of the night. What time is it in Norway? It's 2:12 in the morning. Food critic.
Ooh, that would be fun.
What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say? Food critic?
Yeah, they saw the side shot for the piano.
Come on, mate. What are you saying to me, Leslie?
Right.
Could you block her, please? Just kidding. Door-to-door musician. Not bad. After this next song, I will reveal what I'm doing. It's very exciting. Matter of fact, one of my co-workers is on here. Please just know that you can donate and tip. If 1,000 people gave me $1,000 each. No, if 1,000 people gave me $10. How much is that?
You're asking the wrong guy.
So I think it's $1,000,000. So that would really help. $1 million, I mean, I'll split it with you. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, so this is a song called Sarah. This, I just want to let you know that there's a character called Sarah in the song The Reunion. Sarah in that song wore her smile like a party invitation. Now, that may or may not be accurate with this Sarah, but all I can tell you is that that is not the same Sarah. These Sarahs are separated by at least 2.5 decades. And the actual other person, her name really wasn't Sarah, but I gave her the name Sarah because it sang very well. Matter of fact, Sarah is a great singing name. And that's why I'm going to sing the song Sarah, for many reasons. One of them is it's a great singing name. I think one of the tricky things when you've been in a long-term relationship and it's the only one you've been in...
You call Jeremy Sarah. Yeah.
Yeah. Took the words right out of my mouth. Must have been when I was firing you.
Oh! Burn!
Hey, look, Cindy Brown's there. Glad you blind out. See, Cindy? Cindy's my boss. She might not think about it that way, but she's my sensei. Matter of fact, Sensei Cindy.
Nice.
Cindy is as southern as...
Grits.
As
I don't know.
Southern as grits. Yeah, she's a southern gal, and I like it. She's very encouraging. Cindy's on my team. Cindy's my boss. To please my boss, so I will sing this song. But anyway, this is called Sarah. My beautiful girlfriend Sarah. partner, beautiful, gorgeous, spectacular, wonderful, caring, sensitive, really good
looking.
Keep
going.
Really good looking. I wrote this for her after we'd been dating about 6 or 7 weeks. You're just not sure. You're like, you've had the shit kicked out of you in love, like in relationships. You've had the living shit kicked out of you, and you're just, what? How much was me? How much was the other person? Am I too broken to do this? Can I do this? Can I love someone else? What happened then? Should this have happened? Should that have happened? You're kind of just in this place. And when I was there, I wanted to write this song. And I actually really like this song. So this is called Sarah. Sarah, can you tell me? Are we moving way too fast? They say that if you jump too soon, it's not gonna last. I'm scared that what I'm feeling won't survive the winter snow. Sarah, I don't know, I don't know. Sarah, you're a story I wanna understand. The lightning shoots right through me when I just hold your hand. And I'm scared that what I'm feeling, but my fear may overflow. Bottom of the sea. And if you turn and ask me, will we stay afloat? Sarah, I don't know, I don't know. Yes, Sarah, you're a diamond. They tried to steal your light, but still you keep on shining, even in the darkest night. And if you ask me if I love you, Sarah, please don't go, please don't go. I wanna love somebody just like you. I wanna be loved by someone just like you. I believe the love internalizes the truth. So why not me? Why not you? Why not me? Why not you? Buried it underground. And maybe what I'm feeling is that finally I'm healing. Oh, Sarah, do 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 do. I like that song. I guess you gotta like your own songs.
Good song, Polly.
I like it. I've written crap songs, so I know the good ones when I hear them. Okay, artist promoter? Nope. Let's meet Sarah. Bring her on. That's going to take a $1,000 donation. Are you selling Avon, Kimberly? No. But I will tell you this. I am training to sell health insurance. And I want to tell you, I'm loving it. It's really hard. I'm still working out the software. The menswear. No, I'm still... It's difficult. But I tell you what, the group of people I'm working with are unbelievable. Everyone is amazing. And so I'm going to be selling health insurance. I'm not sure this touring thing's coming back for a while. And so even though I'm going to do some shows, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up my website to be the way that I communicate with every one of you. So I'm going to put everything that I release on my website. I'm not going to probably press any more CDs. And there's going to be a members only section of the website that if you pay a yearly premium, I said like health insurance, there's a deductible and a co-insurance benefit right. When it comes to that. No, there'll be a special section on my website. If you sign up and pay a yearly premium or a membership fee, you will get access to my video log, my blog. I'll read sections of the book that I'm writing. I will release old demos. I'm actually converting 4-track demos to MP3s of when I was 13 and 15 and 18. Some of them are horrendously bad, and that makes it funny.
Nice.
But I'll be releasing all my new music through my website. So that's what I'm going to do for music. I don't think the touring thing's going to happen for a while. Everything's kind of cancelled. And so I'm excited about this new idea. So maybe you need health insurance. Trust me, if I can understand your health system, anyone can.
Oh, man.
It's like trying to find a small piece of spaghetti in a swimming pool of spaghetti. I think that's a terrible analogy, but I think you understand. It is complicated. It is complicated. But you know what? We can simplify it and beat any price out there. My insurance company is called Boomerang Health Insurance. Boomerang Health Insurance. Anyway, the show must go on. I've got just about 3 or 4 more songs to do. I was going to sing a song here called The Symphony of the Redeemed. I am not going to do that tonight. I will do that at the next show. Sorry about that if that was your favourite. But I am going to finish off with at least 2 songs that I have not performed. Well, I performed this first one a few times in Norway, but I've never performed it online or in America or Australia. It's called Are You Looking for Jesus? And I probably should mention that you could donate, but just before I start talking about this song and Jesus, maybe it's not a good time, but I guess I did it anyway, in a passive-aggressive fashion. But you can donate. That would be great, actually. It even rhymes with donate.
Class wants Irish songs.
Class? Class is... a German. Can you block him, please?
Yes, thank just you. Did. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Bye, class.
Any steak knives? I'll tell you what, mate. You buy health insurance off me, I'll buy you the nicest steak knives out there. And a steak. Hey, Alyssa, wait. Alyssa, wish I'd known you were selling health insurance. I got laid off from my job and lost my health insurance. Oh, my gosh, Alyssa. Trust me. I got you, girl. I got you. I got you and your magnificent husband and your new soon-to-be-born baby. Who you're going to call Paula, I've heard. Heather, yes, thank you. Good to see you, Birgit. Symphony of the Redeemed is definitely a favorite. Sorry about that, Birgit. But once again, you're German, so I'm not doing it. Sorry about that. Josiah. Oh, Josiah. I don't care to hear another new song. The reason he's saying that is because Josiah is from this podunk little redneck area of Ohio. And he came down to my house and was sitting on my balcony, and I had something in my house I needed to move inside. And I said, Josiah, can you help me? And he goes, I don't care to. And I went, no, can you just help me? He goes, I don't care to. And I said, why are you being such an ass about it? And he goes, I said, I don't care to. What he meant was, I'll help you. In what part of intelligence would any culture of any people think that the words "I don't care to" would mean "Sure, I'll help you." How about this? Do you love me? I don't care. Do you want to eat? I don't care.
Thank you, Josiah.
I don't care. See, "I don't care" means bad. So that's why he said "I don't care to." Class B. Now, what would a class say there? What did class say?
Class. He said hi.
Oh. Hi, class. Thought he was going to say something funny. "I don't have a beef with Germans. I'm just messing around. I love Germans." Matter of fact, Angela Merkel, who's their prime minister, whatever they call it, she recently spent, I read this on the internet, so it's probably true, she recently went to Greece for the weekend. And believe it or not, she had to go through the regular immigration area. I mean, like a head of state. And they said nationality, and she said German. They said occupation. She goes, "No, I'm just here for the weekend." Anyway, so let me just say, sorry about that. I do love German beef, and actually I adore Germans. They're my faves. But that was a pretty funny gag, I reckon. Anyway, this song's called "Are You Looking for Jesus?" I saw this post yesterday from this religious person saying, it was a meme with a mask on. If Jesus were here, he would wear a mask and he wouldn't get vaccination shots. And I was like, how the hell do you know that? Who are you? Did God send you to speak to us all about stuff like that? I tell you what, man, I'm a Jesus follower, but I got to tell you, I think a lot of the times that the grace that religious people talk about, there's more of it for them than the pagans they're pointing fingers at. Because I'll tell you right now, I think God goes, "Oh, I love them. But goodness me." So this song is called "Are You Looking for Jesus?" Jesus was criticized by the religious people for hanging out with sinners. He was criticized for going to parties. He was criticized for drinking. He was criticized for letting women of the night touch him. He was criticized for the friends that he hung out with. He hung around with tax collectors and prostitutes. The religious people said, there's no way that guy could have anything to do with God because look at the company he keeps. He goes into the middle of a town and he speaks to this guy called Zach. And he goes, "Zach, come out of the tree." And his disciples are like, "Oh my gosh, this is a PR nightmare. That guy is a crook. Everyone's going to think we're idiots now. Jesus, what are you doing?" Jesus has lunch with a guy. We don't even know what he said to him, but the guy ended up giving everything that he'd stolen back. So we know that Jesus transforms people. But I got to tell you, he spends time with anyone and everyone whenever he wants. And he doesn't make them take a bath before they hop in the shower. He takes them just as they are. And he hangs around with anyone, anytime. And don't you dare say that he can't. And he's very not like us. Because he doesn't walk in and see the outside. He looks straight at the heart. Slightly terrifies me. Anyway, so this song is called "Are You Looking for Jesus?" Brand new. Are you looking for Jesus? You wanna find him, yeah. You could start in the churches, but he isn't always there. You may find him with a broken hearted. You may find him with the poor and lame. You won't find him with everybody that calls upon his name. You may find him at the hooker's party or dancing at the Mardi Gras. He might be drinking with the high and mighty and telling jokes at the bar. Are you looking for Jesus? You want to find him, yeah. You can start in the churches, but he isn't always there. You may find him in the Oval Office, serving coffee to the VIPs, or see him down at the border, hanging with his fellow refugees. You may find him in the old cathedral,
always believers that are underground. Washing feet at the mosque on Friday, or with the synagogue Sabbath crowd. Are you looking for Jesus? You wanna find him, yeah. You can start in the churches, but he isn't always there. You tell me that you follow what I'm singing about. You tell me that your faith is real and devout. You tell me what the Bible teaches. You tell me that you're looking for Jesus. You say to the sinner, come to Jesus today. But then you put a minefield right in his way. So tell me as you blow them to pieces, are you really looking for Jesus? Yeah, yeah. Are you looking for Jesus? You wanna find him, yeah. You could start in the churches, but he isn't always there. We lose anyone, Jeremy?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, preach it, amen. Wow, this is the most fun church service I've ever attended. Well, the church is the people. Jana, you tell such wonderful stories with your music. Thank you. Frederick Orland Groff. What a cool name.
Definitely.
Paul, it's nice to hear you again. It's been a long time since I saw you in Vegoshai. Vegoshai, Norway. Vegoshai, Norway made it into my song Snoo.
Sure did.
Matter of fact, there was a lady in Vegoshai who bought the Recalculating album, Jeremy, that you worked on with me.
Yes.
And there was a bonus track where my daughter Ellie, who was 11 at the time, singing this beautiful Emily Dickinson poem set to music. And this lady became a massive fan of that song and of my daughter Ellie. And she recently passed away. And her friend wrote to me and said that that's the song that they played at her funeral over the loudspeaker. Wow. It was my daughter Ellie singing this beautiful song.
That's
man,
awesome.
That was amazing. Lisa, if there are people present, Jesus is there. The question is, will they accept him or kick him out? Lisa's preaching it, man. Why do I have to say anything? She's got it down. Okay, two more songs. This next one is not a kind of normal song for me. It's called Mr. Megalomaniac. I'd like to dedicate this to all the women out there who were single or remarried or with someone else, and the first guy they were with was a total megalomaniac asshole who just shoved them down, didn't listen to them, and was just a real jerk. And also maybe if you had a boss like that. So I thought I'd write a song called Mr. Megalomaniac about that. So this is unreleased as well. You get to the member section of the website, I might send you this song. Mr. Megalomaniac. First time I've ever played this live. He was more than headstrong. He'd say he's right and everybody else is wrong. He told his story every day for so long. It became a rhyme in a sad little song. Please someone ring the gong. And on the stage he did belong. And he made everyone sing along, but not everyone. He was a hard-headed fool. He tried to teach us, but he never went to school. He fell in love with himself and he got fooled. Saw his reflection in the dark swimming pool. It was beautiful. On the outside he was cool. He'd have
deflected shame with ridicule. Hard-headed fool. And she tried just to get a word in. And you'd think she committed a mortal sin. His face red, and with rage he said, how could anybody not believe me? It's crystal clear in the world that I see. How could anybody fail to love me? I don't know. I wish everybody stopped complaining. It's not my fault, but it's you who's draining. I find everybody here so failing, don't you know? And what else was there left to say? It was his way or the nearest highway. But would she drive away? He was a crafty spider once, but now she knew his moves better than anyone. That he kept inside the web he'd carefully spun. Between the past and all the years yet to come. But she spoiled his fun. And somehow she escaped the attack. Like the universe at last had her back. She said, I'll no longer be your snack. So enjoy your life, Mr. Megalomaniac.
Polly, I don't think I've heard that one.
You haven't heard that?
I don't think you've played that for
me. I like it.
Yeah, it's great.
Ah, Cheyenne, you're an amazing songwriter. Oh, stop it. Say it again. Lisa Loftus, I want this song. Okay, so before I sing the last song and fare thee well for the evening, let me say a few things. Number one, you can go to Paul Colman Official.
Official.
And you can donate through Venmo.
There you go.
It should be called Venmo.
You think so?
I said it. Venmo, or PayPal. And
that's much easier.
I also split this with Jeremy. So he's got four children. Think of the children.
Think of the children, no doubt.
I can say with a
straight face. I do it every day.
Guys, think of the children.
Yes.
Watch this. Think of the children.
Thank you, Sarah McLachlan.
The key thing.
Oh, no, she's the pet one. She's the pet.
Now, you know, in a Christian photo shoot, these are the three words you have to think of. Watch this. Approachable, spiritual, sexual. Watch this.
I feel it. All three.
Felt that?
Yes.
Approachable, spiritual, sexual. Watch. It's like the Christian version of Blue Steel. You want to see it again?
It really is.
I want to see.
Okay, watch coming this. Off your head.
Christian photo shoot. Approachable, spiritual, sexual.
Oh my God!
You've got to be looking into the lens at every soccer mom. What I mean is to the Lord.
Love that.
I'd like to finish off with one song. It's called Still Haven't Found What I'm Looking For. It's by my favorite band ever, U2. And I've heard Christians say, what do you mean Still Haven't Found What I'm Looking For? Aren't you a Christian? Yes, settle down and listen to Pauly Pops. What Bono is saying is, I'm still trapped in this body. I'm still on this earth. I've not become complete in the new world yet. I still haven't found the connection I'm looking for. I still battle in this body. Okay, just settle down. You have to think things through. You can't just react to something straight away. You have to think about it. Why am I emphasizing like this? It seems very patronizing, but I can't seem to stop because I'm enjoying myself.
You're just too big a fan. That's what it is. You love it so much.
You know, if they released a fart and a burp to a loop, I'd still say it was the greatest thing I've ever
done. I think you got that last year's membership with you too. Yeah. Yeah, nice.
Matter of fact, can I do the loop and you do the fart sound?
Sure.
Okay.
It needs more reverb, but yes.
Okay, one more time. Jeremy does this great fart sound with his face. Okay, here we go. Wait.
That was a short one for you guys.
Oh my gosh. Okay, guys, I just want you to know... that it's been wonderful sharing this evening.
It really went off the rails, guys. Thanks for hanging with us.
Okay, I was at my my nephew's wedding last year, and I was in the rest in the stall.
Yeah.
And I heard my two other nephews come in and were chatting, and I sat there. I went, and it was echoey, and I heard them go. They're like, "Did you hear that?" And so I went, and they just were laughing and laughing. And I went up to them, like, "What are you guys laughing at?" "Oh my gosh, this guy in the restroom." I said, "That was me, you idiots." And they're like, "Damn it, Uncle Paul."
Uncle Paul again.
Okay, so last thing I want to say is, firstly, you can donate and tip, even if it's a dollar. Actually, don't do that. It's pathetic. At least make it $1.50. Come on. think of the children.
The children, right. What are the three things?
Sexual, approachable, spiritual. Just look at any Al Christian album cover. You're welcome. Oh. You're welcome. Also, you've got to really look very spiritual, because obviously if you write Christian songs, you're way more spiritual than everyone else, which is why you can look like this.
Lovely.
Looking, thinking, man, I just memorized the book of Deuteronomy. Or something. Probably Romans. Most Christians read Paul more than Jesus, but anyway. Cool. Yeah. Jesus didn't have enough doctrine. He really didn't close the deal. There wasn't 3 points. He didn't talk about, you know, homosexuality. He didn't talk that much about, you know, a place of women. I don't feel like I can dig my teeth into Jesus that much. Now, Paul, he had some stuff to say about that. I can really talk about that. Cover your head. Don't speak.
Oh, wow.
You may not be in leadership.
Wow.
Jesus was soft on that stuff, man. What is his deal? Man, I just fully lost the people. I lost people then. I lost all my donations in one fell swoop. Sorry, I'm wrong. Think of the children. Right, one more song. I am going into selling health insurance.
Yes!
Trust me. Trust me when I tell you. Trust me when I tell you. You need to talk to me. I'll simplify it. I ain't going to rip you off. I'm going to help you. And if I can't help you, I'm going to put you on to Sensei Cindy. And she's going to split commissions with me. She's going to give everything to the poor.
Think of the children.
Jeremy's children.
Yes.
Thank you, Jeremy, for being here. Jeremy Michael is going to sing backing vocals on this song.
Oh, well, I'll do my best.
Yeah. So this is called The Slow and Found I'm Looking For by my favorite band in the universe, U2. Thank you for being here. I'll say a little goodbye afterwards, but this is my version of this song. A couple of chord substitutions here too. I have climbed highest mountains, I have run through the fields, only to be with you, only to be with you. I have run, I have crawled, I have scaled these city walls. Only to be with you.
Here we go.
But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Still. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. I have kissed honey lips, felt the healing in her fingertips. It burned like fire.
Like fire.
It's burning me desire. I have spoke tongues of angels. I have held the hand of the devil. It was warm in the night. I was cold as a stone. See it? But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. I believe
come. All the colors will bleed into one, bleed into one. Yes, I'm still running. You broke the bonds and you loosened the chains. Carried the cross, you took my shame, you took the blame. Oh yeah, you know I believe it. Yes, I do. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Yeah. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Sing it again, bro.
But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Jeremy Michael, woo! Legend. Anyway, folks, it's been awesome. Thank you for being with me. Any more Life Plus comments? Wow, listen to the harmony. Yeah, Kimberly Kelly.
Yeah.
Yeah, mate.
Think of the children. Well done, Andrew.
That's Andrew. He's in Australia. He's come from a Greek background. Mikulachilia. Bono was jealous of Paul's talent. Appreciate the sentiment, but that would be a hard no.
That's about it. Let me see some new ones here.
Wait, who's that?
Where?
Dwayne Melton. That's a cool name.
Shaw is.
I never regret just donating to Paul. Thank you, Lisa. I never regret putting it in my bank and paying my bills. Yeah, beautiful. Oh, Elaine. Hi, Elaine. You sweetheart, you. That's Chopper Charlie's mother-in-law. Opa! Did you know what I actually said to you, Anthony, in Greek? That's what I want to know. Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Adair. Tash. Hey, Tash. Katrina. Yeah. All right, folks. If you want to donate, I split that with Jeremy every time we do this. The children.
Sexual, spiritual.
Sexual, spiritual, emotional. One last time. Are you trying to do a close-up?
No.
Thank you. I might do another one. Matter of fact, I'm thinking about doing one that's just purely Larry Norman songs, because Larry Norman's one of my favorite artists.
That's a good idea.
I might do that.
Yeah.
But we'll see. But just know two things. Number one, selling health insurance. Need health insurance? Polly Pops. Yeah. Boomerang health insurance. Website will be coming soon. I can help you. Matter of fact, you know what? If you don't understand health insurance or you have health insurance, let me talk to you anyway, because by talking to you, I'll understand my job better. It's only been 3 weeks. Maybe you can teach me something. So if you're happy with your health insurance, let me know why. I'll learn why, and then when I talk to the next person, you'll help me. You don't even have to want to buy it to call me. Just help me. Help me. I have to learn. Help me, Jerry. Help me.
Help me.
Help me.
Help you.
Help you.
That's right.
And the other thing, too, is that when PaulColman.com comes back on the air, we had some issues with the URL, and it got lost. And so we did Paul Colman Official, but obviously it's a bit of a mouthful. So Paul Colman Official is where you can find out everything. So thank you. Thank you so much for being with me. Any last comments that I need to respond to here? Oh, Christina! Christina's in North Carolina. Her husband is Mike. I stay with them when I'm out there singing to the Marines. And I got to tell you, there's some serious karaoke parties there. I had to get up early. They were raging into the night.
I really like this comment.
Which one? Philip Davis. My boys, hang on. My boys named our barbecue Paul. It's a Colman, by the way. Hey, now, Philip Davis. He's a cool guy. He lives in Canada. And he knows more of my songs than I think I do.
Oh.
And he performs them to people.
Oh.
And I saw him at a festival, and I was about to sing one of my songs, and I pulled him out of the crowd, and I let him sing it. I was getting paid. I thought it felt good. I was like, yeah, you go for it. And I sat down with a drink of water. You go for it, mate. Go on, get up there. He was awesome. Sue, thank you. I can't wait till you can test my brain. Slightly terrified, but slightly excited.
I'm interested to hear the results.
Yeah. Mikey will come and sing American Pie. That's right. At that bar where we did karaoke. Yeah. All right. Okay, thanks, guys. God bless you. Really appreciate you being here. Let everyone know that this is going to be on my YouTube channel. Please subscribe. That helps. I can start advertising Christian photo shoots.
Where you can hit all 3 points.
Right, right, exactly.
Yes.
And don't forget, health insurance. Help my first month be a boomer. Rang. God bless you guys. Thank you. Adios.